Hey guys, and welcome to episode 21. First game today, we're going to be playing Charlton in the Championship. If you missed the previous episode, quickly just fill you in. We went out the Carlton Cup if you missed that episode a few episodes back against Chelsea. We are still in the FA Cup. We had a replay game against Nottingham Forest, I believe. We're still top of the Championship. Things are going well. Sacco got sold. This is just a quick recap, just in case anyone's sort of wants to just catch in this episode. It's been quite a eventful season. Like I said, players wanting to leave, a few players surprising us, but the squad is doing well. We've got a really big squad and we're really well in the Championship. We went to the semi-finals at the Carling Cup or the Capital One Cup, or whichever one you prefer. But like I said, it's been going really well. This game, at the start of the game, like this whole first half was pretty much boring, so there's not many highlights. Like I said, the block there, I managed to, like, the guy tackles me there. It's a really bad tackle as well, so he manages to pick up I think it was either two yellows or was it a straight red? Might have been a straight red. Like I said, he gets sent off there, so they're down to 10 men. Like I said, the first half of this game was very boring. Nothing happened whatsoever. You'll see the stats as well. Although, actually, now I think about it, when we look at the stats, it will be quite deceiving, because I had six shots, four on target. Believe me, they weren't that good. But anyway, nice little passing movement here. Savile turns his player and smashes it past the keeper to make that 1-0 to us. Great goal. We was always going to get goals in the second half. The fact that they're down to 10 men, I don't think they replaced the player with a defender. I think it was a defender that got sent off, and I don't think they replaced him. But, yeah, like I said, Savile smashing it past the keeper. It was always going to be easier. Like, it's easier to play against 10 men. Although some people say it's harder to play against 10 men. It depends how you play, I suppose. Maybe the players work harder because they know there's a player missing. I don't know. But like I said, we managed to pick up the goal there. Savile picking up the goal. Akpom as well. If you don't know, we bought him from Arsenal in the January transfer window because Sagbo went back to Hull. But like I said, we picked him up. Anyway, nice little finesse. Like a nice little placement shot there from Henry. Just placing it past the keeper to make that 2-0 after us. I feel sorry for Henry because we got so many decent, like really, 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 really good wingers. It's just difficult to get into the team. Parra, Jacobs, who else is that? When we had Sacco was playing there. I'm trying to think at the top of my head. Like I said, like, it's just that position is so up for grabs at the moment, it's ridiculous. But anyway, here's Parra. Threw on goal. They tried to get the goal back, so they left themselves open at the back. Tried a little bit of skill, it didn't come off, but we still managed to pick up the goal there. Got a bit lucky, maybe should have just finessed it. Tried to be a bit cocky, if you want to say. But yeah, Parra doing a little sidestep, boom, boom, and then putting it into the back of the net to make that 3-0 to us. Parra, by the way, is turning into that player for us, like how important Sacco was for us. He's slowly turning into that player. He's quick, he can finish. So we're going to see how far we can take him, and I might have to offer him a new contract or give him a just to fend off the other clubs, because I don't want him to leave at all, because he's amazing. The one thing I do think they should put in FIFA, though, is that a set buyout clause, although I suppose I reckon some people might be a bit stupid with it, like putting £1 billion or something like that. I don't know, like a cap or something like that. Just so, like, if you want the player, I know they did it with this, like, you know, a counter offer, but if you want to purposely go to your transfers in your squad and you say, okay, if someone wants to buy him, this is a set price for him, like, regardless, like, I don't want no offers under that. But, I don't know. I think that would be quite cool. Or if you could do it in the comments, like, you know, you do like a pre-match conference or something like that. Just say, like, or just, like, you know, talk more about the squad. Because the only thing you can do is praise, motivate, or unnerve the opposition. I think that's a bit shit. I think there should be more stuff you should be able to talk about. Like, maybe transfer rumours that have been going around, or the fact that a player might be injured, how you're going to replace him, like, how you're going to approach the game. All you can do is just praise and motivate. And I don't get me wrong, I don't think that's good. I just wish there was a bit more you could do in the press conference, but maybe they'll do it in the future, I don't know. But anyway, our next game is against Blackburn. Blackburn are a weird squad, cause to be fair, when they came down to the Championship, I honestly thought that they would go back up to the Premiership straight away, because there was a decent squad when they was in the Prem, so shit happens. As you probably saw there as well, the size of our squad is ridiculous. But a few of them, their contracts run out in the summer anyway. Like it's Roger Johnson. He won't be with us in the summer because his contract runs out, so he'll be gone. Like I said, in the summer, we will be getting rid of a lot of dead wood and just replacing it with a lot more, you know, because we're going to be in the Premiership. We want some big boy talents. I'm also considering going legendary when we hit the Prem. I think it's a bit too late to do it now, although I could still do it. But I think once we hit the Prem, we should probably play on legendary just to make it a tad bit harder. Not the greatest start to this game, and a nice little 1-2 with the Blackburn players. Goalie maybe should have done better there, to be honest. But like I said, beating at his near post. But they managed to take the lead anyways. 1-0 to them. Pretty much from the start of the game, really. Like I said, goalie really should have done better, beating at his near post. Nice little 1-2 though. Like, that's a nice little 1-2. My player's not really tracking their runs, but nice anyway. Managed Parra doing a little bit of skill here. Look at that. Look. Come on. Oh, and then it takes me down in the box. That's a blatant penalty. It's got to be a penalty. It's got to be a red card as well. Oh, it's only a yellow. It's only a yellow card, but we still get the penalty at the end of the day. Pretty much straight after they scored as well. Parra, like I said, is slowly turning into that guy for us. Like, seriously, he might actually start to become unplayable because something about him is just skillful, quick, fast, can finish. Like, it reminds me of Sako a lot. Imagine if I had Sako on one wing and him on the other now, but. Anyway, Jacob's going to take a penalty, smash it past the keeper to his left side. Boom, we bring it back 1-0. Cameraman, look at him, getting it right in his face. Kicks the corner flag over, celebrates for the fans. Great comeback already. You know, we didn't want to be behind for too long. Quickly, I just want to talk about penalties. Don't you think penalties in this game are a bit easy to just concede? Like, it's just a bit ridiculous. But Parra, look at that, skipping, bobbing in, out, and then boom. Straight into the back of the net. I told you, he's getting too good. He's seriously getting too good. I'm going to have to check his squad report just because how good he's getting. Because he's got to be at least rated 90 by now or something like that. Look at that. Skips in and then boom, in. Smashes past the keeper. Keeper didn't have a chance in the world. I think their keeper was Paul Robertson as well. It's hard to believe he used to play for England and now he's like, I don't even know how old he is now. I'm not saying he's old because keepers normally last till about 40 or something like that. But it's just shocking because it seems like he's been in the game for years. Anyway, we're going to the half there, 2-1. Although we started off sloppy, we managed to bring it back just in time for the half-time break. Half-time break. What am I talking to sound like I'm American for? They're the other scores from the games. Like I said, we're pretty much far ahead in the championship now, so don't have to worry. There's a lot of shots in that game. It was a very open game. Possession, we probably slacking on. Blackburn, you know, having a lot more. Not a lot more of it, but, you know, a bit more of it. We're going to have to change that in the second half. A bit of tappy-tappy. Going to have to give Pep Guardiola a call. Anyway, look at this. Oh, this goal really frustrates me. You'll see why. Look, my defender gets out the way. He gets scared and puts his head down. That's what really pisses me off. I think I'll even show the replay on this one because it annoys me that much. Watch, like, he does a little, passes it, cuts back. Watch my defender. He ducks his head. Ah, that's annoying. If that was John Terry or someone, he would have thrown his head in front of it. Well, look, it was a side foot as well. That's annoying. Anyway, we take advantage of some dodgy defending here. Parra. I'm going to have to name this episode Parra because he's that good. Manages to just pick it up and then place it into the back of the net. Ridiculous. He wins us the penalty and he's got 2 goals for us so far in this game. Come on, tell me he's not turned into that important guy for us, you know, so far this season. Look at that. Nabs it off the defender. I don't know what the defender was doing. He's in no man's land. Anyway, they managed to whip the ball in. Nice header, like, you know, just went past the post. But for some reason, I gave away a penalty, and I'm still baffled as to how, because I pressed X in the air, like, to pass it away. But look, what happened? I don't get what happened. Oh, that's so frustrating. They managed to pick up a penalty as well. To think the worst part is we're near the end of the game, which makes it even more annoying. Oh, so, I mean, penalty, like I said earlier, penalties are just too easy to give away in this bloody game. Tried to put him off with a little bit of dancing in the goal, as you can see. You know, trying to put him off, but it doesn't matter. You smashed it past my keeper anyway to make it 3-0. 6 goals in this game, bloody hell. Ugh, see, I'm really pissed off about that penalty. I don't think it's a penalty at all. I mean, all you have to do is press circle these days and just give away a penalty. Anyway, corner comes in and then boom, look at that. Last minute, and we managed to pick up a goal. I think it's Danny Bath, was it? Yep, that guy. I don't think he scored many for us this season. I think that might be actually his first one. Because I'll have to go back through the episodes, but I can't. I don't think he scored another one. I don't think he has. But look at that. You know, picking up the points at the end when we need a nice header. Placed it past Paul Robertson to make that 4-3. 7 goals in this game, which is ridiculous. Oh, it's getting crazy. Anyway, like I said, that brings it to the end of the game to make that 4-3 to us. We managed to pick up the 3 points. Parra has to be man of the match. There's no one else. Like I said, Parra, look, I told you, he had to be man of the match. It was just, look at my shots. We had 18. Ridiculous. Anyway, I'm just going to bring this episode to a close. got a bit of a cough at the moment. And it's going to bring this episode to a close. If you did like it, please give that a like. And if you're new around here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Quickly, when this season finishes, I will be going into doing another series with Wolves in the Premiership, just to see how we get along, see if we can get into the Champions League. We'll see how it goes anyway. Like I said, that will be on Legendary anyway. So like I said, I want to thank you for watching. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Christmas time soon, so you know. Woo! Anyway, like I said, hope you're having a wonderful day, and I'll see you in episode 22. See you guys. Peace! We'll